Denver 7 On Demand is brought to you by Ferguson and BAC Appliance Center, the best in bath, kitchen, and lighting for your home.
I'm Jacqueline Allen with the latest from Denver 7. 12,000 fans decided to stay home instead of traveling to Mile High Stadium for the Broncos finale against the Chargers. Those fans didn't miss much. The Broncos offense was a dumpster fire and the team lost 23-9, making this the first time they've lost 10 or more games in back-to-back seasons since the 1960s. Tomorrow, Kelsey Barrett's fiance will be in court charged in her murder. Barrett, a 29-year-old mother from Woodland Park, has not been seen since Thanksgiving. Investigators are still searching for her body in both Colorado and Idaho, which is where her cell phone last pinged. We will be in court tomorrow, and we will bring you any new developments on the free Denver 7 app.
Oh, no way.
Here is an Only in Colorado moment. A Denver 7 viewer, Christina, sent us this video from her carriage ride in Breckenridge. Three giant moose locking antlers in the snow. And from the First Alert Weather Center, Stacy Donaldson is here with a look at your First Alert Action Day. Stacy?
It's about to get much colder along with snowfall. Today, highs were in the low 50s. Tomorrow, our temperatures will keep dropping throughout the day till we hit 12 degrees in the afternoon. We'll have snowfall here for the Front Range, which is why we were under a First Alert Action Day. Winter weather advisory also in effect for 3 to 6 inches of snow. Our overnight low around 1 degree for your New Year's Eve celebrations. It'll be a cold new year with a high of 19. And then we'll be in the 40s and 50s as we head toward the end of the week and the weekend.
And this has been your Denver 7 On Demand update. Thank you for joining us. Drive carefully out there and check out back later tonight for another update. Download the Denver 7 app for breaking news and alerts. I'm Jacqueline Allen.